Hazel linked combos with Tahm Kench in the back line for the initiation, but they'll have the movement speed to do it. It is still, again, focused around specifically the poke under touch.
Now the fast track down. Brown's going to be a bit late.
Kyubey can't be there.
Yeah, Smeb now coming in. Kyubey can't arrive. That's going to be the Infernal Drake going over to rocks. But can they pick up any kills? Exhaust coming out onto Ambition. They lock him down with the Chain of Corruption. Smeb's going to eat him, spit him out. And that is actually going to be first blood coming in at 17 minutes as Kuro picks up the kill for his Varus. Nicely played by the Hawkshot, but now Smeb roaming up Kyubey, just trying to juke out as best as he can. But here comes Smeb. The hop's already been used. The tongue's not going to connect, but he still have a good amount of damage. He's going to transform. Actually doesn't even get the chance. The burst there from Peanut is just too much. And now push coming back in onto the mid side. The TP
very straightforwardly might actually force a QSS out of the time.
Oh catch. Boy,
here
actually,
comes Kyubey.
This is bad. Kyubey comes in with a flash, finds two into the wall, follows up, and here comes Samsung just piling in. Smeb arrives, does nom up Kuro, keeping him alive for the time being. They're actually going to be able to fire back and take out Ambition. So Rock's turning this around where it looked so bad for them just a couple seconds ago. The very aggressive ult coming through from Smeb with Prey in tow. They get onto Kyubey. They get on a ruler. They take him down, and now Peanut duking it out with Wraith. He's going to have to flash away, jump to the side with his W.
Available to try to lock up this Rock's Tigers lineup, and the two-man Gnar wasn't enough. The Baron damage was always sky-high, and there it goes. Rock's Tigers said it was a chess game. Well, we're pretty close to checkmate in the Samsung. This time.
He does. He's building it up. Actually has a really good way to go in. Prey going to get caught out. Now they knock him into the wall, but Smeb is there to devour the Sivir. So overall, the engage there from Samsung not going to be very effective. Prey does have to flash out to safety as Crown is just wailing away on him with those Sand Soldiers. The ruler really low, and then here comes the Nom now onto Kyubey, who barely makes it out alive. Smeb going pretty low, has that shield still, and Koro is just going to pop ruler in the back line. This fight is now opened up for Rox, who can just push forward and try to get the kill in. Huge burst of damage from the Rain of Arrows coming in there onto Wraith. Crown will find a kill on the Peanut.
Varus either.
Yep. It's going to be the Chain of Corruption coming out. Ambition taking a hell of a lot of damage. Peanut goes in deep, finds the kill, and now is looking for another one. Flashes in on the ruler, jumps on top of him. That's going to be a double kill for Peanut. This is why you don't give him Nidalee. Meanwhile, the backside of the fight, the Emperor's Divine comes out here from Crown,
triple
but it
kill.
Just does not matter. It's a triple kill now for Peanut. Looking quadra? For the Quadra. Can he find it? No! Kuro going to take that one away with the piercing arrow, but Rock's Tigers are going to come out on top. 31 and a half minutes here, about 30 seconds faster than game one, and they will take down Samsung 13-1 in a very convincing performance.
In emphatic fashion, they find themselves once again top of the table in the regular season. Now, SKT haven't played, and if they win their series, they will be ahead.